Hey, what's up, fuckers? We right back with it. Hit that share this joint. Hit the like button. You know what I mean, subscribe if you haven't yet. Tell your people to subscribe. We need that. Need our view hours and all that. You know what I mean? Got your man Jake from. Yo, they played against each other in the championship game in college. The one that Jalen Hurts got snatched out of. I wonder if Fromm was cooking his ass. I might have to go look at that shit. He ain't even cook him today, though. Jalen Hurts is motivated. So, yeah, you see it. It really wasn't a comparison. It's not at all. Well, yeah, that's right. They pulled Fromm. They put Glennon in. So, yeah, man. So now this dude Sirianni about to start talking. We're going to see what... What he gonna say, because, you know, he likes to. Anyway, we just want to hear what he gonna say. We're not saying he ducking questions and stuff, but we're gonna see what he got to say as far as why he was upset. I want to know why he was upset, because I don't know. Like, I know that they blew the play dead on the... And he didn't like that, because, you know, like, Bart Scott might could have had a touchdown. But still, like, I felt like it was more like if it was built up or something, because, well, damn, Mike Glennon had a better throwing day, 7 for 17.
Wayne.
He's tech.
Yeah.
Here's Nick Sirianni at the podium.
What's the name of the play called, Elaine?
East Texas. East Texas. Oh. Some of those gadgety ones you don't try to name everything because it's hard to name it all, so you kind of come up with a specialized name, and East Lane's from Texas. East Texas, and that's what we called it.
He said it was a play that he had been talking about during the game, Lane. Did you hear that, and did you go with that?
Because I'm sorry, say that one more time.
Devontae said that Lane had been talking about being open or running that play throughout the game. Is that true?
Well, Lane wasn't eligible until that very play, so Lane couldn't have been open. I don't know. I don't know what Devontae is thinking right there. We had a lot of confidence in the play because of the way we practiced this week, and, you know, just confidence in Lane. That, I mean, Lane's a phenomenal football player. You know, I don't agree that he's not in the Pro Bowl. I think that you got a chance to have a guy who's going to be a first or second team All Pro, and not in the Pro Bowl. And so it was great to be able to get him a touchdown.
Philly, you know, when you barbers out of Philly, just walk over to the state, just get a ride up to the stadium. Just knock on the door. Yeah, my name's DJ such and such. Yeah, I be rapping and shit too, but enough for all that. I came here to give Nick Sirianni, the coach, a haircut.
He just deserves so much credit.
And Fran Duffy too, while you at it, because he be killing it with them suits and sharp ass ties, but man, he got a fucked up ass haircut, man.
It's so much more credit than he's getting. This guy is just... I've never been around an offensive tackle that has as talented as this guy is. Like, he could play tight end if he wanted. You should see him throw the football. This guy is so immensely talented. I just got so much respect for him. And it was nice. It's always great when you can reward guys that don't get in the end zone with a touchdown like that. And so... I think it was his first touchdown since high school. I'm sure he scored a lot of them in high school, because the guy's just a stud, and just so happy that he's anchoring our, you know, he's anchoring our offensive line, and look forward to the accolades that he's going to get, because he deserves them.
Nick, how long have you been repping that play? Has that been in for a while? Or is it...
That's not a play that can be in each week. We've had it in the plan before. When it fits. Again, it doesn't fit against every team and every system, so... It's been in the plan before, so we've had reps of it, but, you know, it hasn't been in a couple weeks. So, again, just a great job by our coaches and our players. You know, the detail of how the coaches installed the play, and then obviously the detail of the way the players executed the play, you know, being able to accomplish that in a short week.
Do you feel like the short turnaround in your absence this week affected?
I don't. We, you know what? Our defense played an outstanding game. Like, we all know that, how they came out and they were hitting them right from the beginning. Obviously, you never want to start a game on special teams by putting the ball on the ground right to start. JJ was there to get the fumble recovery, but you don't want to do that. You know, we definitely weren't executing the way we need to execute. But I got so much respect for that defensive coordinator and those that defense that we just played today. I think that's a really, really outstanding defense. That's a great defensive line. That's a Coach Graham, I think, is just a really good coordinator that I've had a lot of respect for a lot of years now. So, again, you got to say, anytime you start off that way and you only score 3 points in the first half, it's always going to be, you know, we didn't coach well enough for sure. We didn't play well enough. But hats off to them because that's a good defense. So it's a combination, all three. I don't put anything into the short week. This team's handled adversity all year, you know, through different things. And that's just what you have to do in the NFL. You have to handle adversity.
He got some fucking nerve. How you going to say that's a great defense? Just got their asses fucking handed to them the second half, 34 to nothing. The second half, 31 unanswered points. We supposed to sit here like you got a thumb up our ass and believe you when you say that's a great defense. Fuck out my face with that dumb shit. We just handed them 31 unanswered in the second half. Come on, man.
Is going to go the way you think it's going to go, just perfectly smooth the whole time. And our teams handle adversity, and I think that has a lot to do with who our leaders are on this team and our captains. You know, with Jason Kelsey and Fletcher Cox, and Rodney McLeod, Jalen Hurts, Alex Singleton, Brandon Graham. Those guys lead the way.
You got to get on it quicker.
You know, so just a lot of credit to our leaders
on this
team.
Run the fucking ball to set up the pass. Run the fucking ball. You got to fucking play action in there, a screen or something. Shit, nigga, you want pass. These dudes, like, we a running team, dude. We a running team. I get it. You want to have him throw a shitload of passes so he can have a low average, so you can offer him mediocre money. I get it. Fuck that. We don't got no time for that shit. Development. This is a quick league, man. This fucking parlor games y'all be playing.
Coming out of halftime, what was said to the offense and the team when you guys were back in the locker room?
You know, just that, hey, good teams win games however they need to win games. You know, if we have to grind this out and be grimy and let the defense carry the way the whole time, we'll do it that way. But, hey, just have that.
We don't have to. Run the fucking ball. What are you playing games for? Fucking word games. Oh, we'll do however we have to. Run the ball. We got a strength. You acting like we weak.
That next play mentality of forget the first half.
Insulting our intelligence for real, trying to act like we don't know that we have a real strength. We got a real attribute. We got something. We the number one rushing team in the league. Because we can run it really good. So, you know, like, we should probably come out just running it to establish the run. You know, show that we are dominant. And then when they're, like, kind of stuck, you know, hit them with a play action over the top, you know what I mean? Maybe a little screen to the left, you know what I mean? Rager, who knows? I don't know, man. This shit, I know, it's just Madden.
And have that next play mentality and come out and ready to go. And they definitely did a good job of, you know, of coming out and just and forgetting that. They did exactly that. They forgot the first half and they executed in the second half. Again, it was just, I think that's a combination of just how our entire offense played. He definitely missed some throws in the first half that he's going to want back. And I thought he went to the right place with the ball. I know there's a question about, you know, Bob prepped me for a question about a red zone play that we threw to Quez over the middle. Guys, you just, when there's guys breaking this way and breaking that way, you have to alert a certain player, which I'll just try to explain to you as much as I possibly can without giving anything away. You alert a certain player and then your read starts somewhere else. So our alert was to Dallas versus a certain coverage. It wasn't that coverage. So now, you know, we read shallow to angle. And that's what he read. So his eyes aren't there. So I'm not one bit concerned. Like, when you give a quarterback and you say to him, when you know their reads as a coach, you don't ever get on him when he misses something like that, because it's not a miss. His eyes went here to here, and Dallas is only a pre-snap read. Jalen doesn't know that they're going to bust. They busted the coverage. Jalen doesn't know at the beginning of that play that they're going to bust that coverage. Like, they made a mistake. They were out of position on that particular play, and that was the read. And so I want to make sure that everybody understands that. And so, again, he didn't play his best first half, and when we play good, when he plays good, the offense rolls. And he did a just great job bouncing back that second half. And again, it's just not having Jalen. We didn't play good as in the skill positions. We didn't play as good as we played on the offense line. We didn't coach as good as we needed to coach.
That's the part. Say that fucking part.
But again,
we know,
just a credit to Jalen to rebound and play a good second half. Because that's what good teams do. They find ways to win. I think again, it just speaks to the leaders that we have in this team and the fact that we knew adversity is going to come. That's just the way this league is. Adversity hits, whether it's a 2-5 start, whether it's a postponement of a game and having to play two games, play a game off a 13-day rest or whatever it was, and then play a game off five. I mean, that's what happens in this league. So you try to prepare yourself for adversity and be able to handle it. And that's the whole message that we've talked about from the beginning of just dog mentality, next play, next play, next play. Jason Kelce gave a message to the team last night, which was awesome, and his message was press on. Bad things happen, press on. Press on. Press on, press on. He was awesome talking to the team last night. He's just such a great leader. And so it all comes back to the types of guys that we have in that locker room. A ton of credit, obviously, to Howie and his staff of how they've assembled this team. I said to Howie in there, Howie said, great job coming back from a 2-5 start. I said, Howie, great job. Like, what other first-year head coaches are in the position I'm in? We have a great offense and defensive line. Usually when there's a new head coach, it's because the offense and defensive line aren't any good. And so it's just been a great team effort, the great organization that we're a part of. And then it always comes down to these players and the type of leaders that we have.
Couple more, please.
The Kelce thing, actually, is that abnormal, or do you have somebody address the team every week?
Well, it's been 12 weeks. One through 12 week, I addressed them. They were probably tired of hearing my voice, so I changed it up. And that's something I've done in the past. I've been on teams that have done that in the past. Frank's done that. Let your captains hear, talk at the end of the year and get the guys ready to go on the Saturday night. I've always had good experience with that.
How big was the interception by Rodney McLeod? You guys had that pick, set up a score. You had a pick six later in the game, iced the game. I mean, all praise to Jalen and the receivers in the second half, but your defense won this game for you.
They played incredible. There's no doubt. The defense kept the game when it wasn't going well, right? And huge, huge play by Rodney. Unbelievable rush by Jannard Avery just to get pressure on the quarterback in the game that they played up front. And so you get that pressure, he sails the ball high, and Rodney gets a big play. And it was 3-3 at that time, I believe, right? And that was their first drive of the second half. I mean, that was everything, right? I mean, you end up going up 7. The defense feels like they're not going to get any more points. And we're like, we're up 7. We ain't freaking losing this game because the way our defense is playing. And our defense knew that. And so, obviously, they played unbelievable. It was the whole game of the pressure, how good they were in the run game, how good we were, covering and taking away some of the dink and dunks. Because that wind was blowing a little bit more than I think people realize out there today. It didn't look bad like in certain spots, but you see the flags up at the top, they were humming. And so just a great job by our defense. And then the pick six, obviously that was huge. It put the game out of reach. We were able to take some guys out after that. And it always starts up front, and just a great job by our defensive line, and then trickled down to everybody.
Our last touchdown, what was your vantage point on Devontae's touchdown? And it seemed like a strange review. It seemed really clear what was happening.
Yeah, I think they were – there might have been – I don't know exactly, but I thought it was a touchdown that they were viewing.
Look, man, what it was they were trying to say that the Devontae Smith didn't secure the catch through the process of the fall. Feel me? Or he didn't secure the ball through the process of catch, rather. But, like, it doesn't make sense that the ground can't cause a fumble when you're inbounds, right? But the ground can cause an incomplete pass when you're in the end zone and you're out of bounds. That doesn't make sense. So I'm glad that they called, they made that odd ass call. Like, yeah, because like you can't, you gotta have, if you're gonna force Lane Kiffin or that guy from the Jaguars, that coach, if you're gonna force that guy Urban Meyer out of the Jaguars because you need the small market, you know, surefire quarterback to succeed and be to, you need that quarterback to prove that this small market is worth going to, you can still win there and you know, make money there, then you also have to do that for your Heisman Trophy winners. You know, Devontae Smith and Devontae Smith has championships, has a champion, I don't know if he has one or two championships, but he has a championship, he's a Heisman winner. You know, Jalen Smith is a champion. He has, I think, two championships, and he won one himself. You know, those are not dudes that you just scoff at. Like, those are dudes that you want. You want, those are stars. Those are stars in the making, you know. You can't just squabble that. They bring ratings. And I think the league saw that. Like, oh, we can't just do them dirty like we do every year. We got to. They gotta get treatment, get fair treatment. So I was happy to see that reversed. But it's about time to get some fucking fair treatment.
And basically something happened. It might have went to a TV commercial. I don't know exactly what happened, but they came back and the time when I thought they were reviewing it, whatever was happening, and then they decided to review it, and yeah, hey, I'm just glad it counted. I don't know. It felt like a long time we had to wait for it, but the refs, I thought the refs did a good job, and they were communicating with us the entire game. Again, their job's never easy, and I value what they do out there.
What about the catch itself?
Yeah, just Devontae's been really good on the back line and on the sideline all year, you know, and that's something you got to learn, right? Because you only have to have one in college, right? And so he's just been really good and clean with his footwork on the sideline for his first year. I mean, he's a technician, and it's just not. And the guy loves football and wants to be better at football. That's, and we know that says, you know, a guy can go from here to here because of the technique he plays with. And so Devontae works endless hours to do that. And he's just, and again, he had the catch like that last week where he dragged the foot from behind. So great job to Aaron Moorhead of drilling that as well. I know he drills that every single day. And then Devontae obviously playing with great technique.
Thanks, guys.
I miss
anybody. Thank you, Coach. Nick Sirianni addressing the media post-game as the Eagles win.
Blue glasses, man. Like, 06 and shit. He listens to Drake. Don't mind him. Yeah, so you already know. Stay up. Take care. God bless. I mean, like, share, subscribe. About to put something in the air. Maybe take a nap. I'm starting to get tired. I ain't going to hold you. Boom. Hit that PayPal.